just put it to the side for a little while. If you come back to it, if you find your mind drifting away from me, that's okay. Just focus back. Yeah. Okay. You are safe. As long as I can be. And it's okay also if you're having trouble sleeping and you don't fall asleep, that's okay. I'll be here just kicking in. Can I show you something that I saw? Sorry if that was freaky deaky. That is what they are. Unfortunately, I think you can't really see this, but my mic now looks like a little person. Maybe can I hold them up here so you can see? Ready? Ready for this to turn into a little friend? A little one-eyed friend. I had these for a project. Teaching elementary school for April Fool's Day, we went around the school and turned everyday objects into creatures with these googly eyes. Apparently I still have them. They've been sitting on my desk that whole time. Yeah. this is the lavender forward one. Let's see, I'm gonna spritz a little bit of it. Oh, that was a disappointing spritz. There we go. Okay, spritz some onion. Lavender is such a good smell. Is what I mean. I was suddenly going in a little spiral. Because maybe like you, I'm having a bit of a night tonight. Feeling a little bit anxious. I am feeling just weird sensations. way. I act like a fucking weirdo. I didn't realize that I didn't. You know what I mean? I realized it was him, like, as I was passing him. He didn't look up. I didn't stop. So I go into the coffee shop, and I'm like, stretches. Or I could just scrunch up my face. It's funny when you scrunch up your face on me. Make it as small as you can. Sometimes I feel like that gets on all my energy sometimes. I almost had gotten away with not saying hello. And I was like, okay, this is actually not restful or restorative. This is becoming anxiety producing. I was planning on going for a walk after, so I got up and I was going to get a box for my food. And I go over to the counter and I'm trying to get someone's attention, but everyone's busy. Standing there, kind of wanting to run away as fast as I can, but I paid good money for my salad, and I wanted to take my salad, you know. I'm a practical girl when it all comes down to it, and where I was standing at the counter, where it was like, across the room was my friend, my crush, and all of his friends. And if he looked up, he would have, like, seen me. And so I'm like, oh, look at the little girl here, because I wanted to, like, play under the radar. And of course, no one comes over. But then I see where the stack of boxes is, but it's behind these two people who are on a date, and they're talking very intimately. So I have to go and say, I'm so sorry, excuse me, can I grab a box from behind you? It's on the counter, like, behind them. And they're like, oh, sure. But in the process, it kind of makes us know if that's gonna melt. Is it too close to the metal? What do we think? But yeah, she lied about rainbow fish. It was my rainbow fish. And then as I told her, she got. To do with the concert I committed to going. decided this for myself, that I'm not gonna buy a hardback book. If I can help it, I just don't. I don't know what it is. And one would think they're so nice to tap on, like. That's the spine of a hardback book. Special, or one of my most favorite crystals. I can't remember what this is called, and I think that it's gonna make me sad that I can't remember what it's called. I got it a couple of years ago at this really, really cool weird things shop in Portland, and I was with my best friend. I was a geology major, like, I love a rock, I love a good rock, but, like, I don't, like, crystals for me, like, I was really, obviously, I'm very into tarot, I like astrology, like, all that woo-woo business, but for me, crystals are kind of the thing, I think, especially when I was a geology major, too, like, so many of the professors spoke really disparagingly about, like, reflects this kind of light blue, and this one, some people talk about store all our materials down there, but often when a new Spanish teacher was hired, they wouldn't clean out the stuff that was down there. And the science teacher, when she came, there was all this stuff in the science closet, which she never cleaned out because it was from the previous science teacher. And a bunch of it was rocks, was all these rock samples. And so she knew that I had majored in geology. And when she was cleaning it out, we had to clean it out. Why did we have to clean it out? I can't remember. But she was like, sure. And it was long before my crystal era. It was still in my rock nerd era. I mean, I would say those two eras really have overlapped. Though my rock knowledge is not as bountiful as it was back in the day. But yeah, so this is from that. And I have a bunch of other little fossils and pieces of petrified wood and whatnot. That I've burned for evidence in the burning things on the new moon. Nope, on the full moon. To release them. I've done it for maybe the past 3 or 4 years. Almost every full moon, I think. I'll do a full moon ritual, and it just helps me feel more connected to the earth as well. And so powerless, it giving me feel so powerless. But I think, in truth, what I would like to release the most is the feeling the need to control, and just the trust that I will feel less weird sometime, and just allowing the really getting into the woo-woo nitty-gritty of like what I do to connect with myself and to help myself when I'm feeling fucking weird.